invite everybody to please stand and turn towards your left and direct your attention toward the entrance of the church. As we gather for the funeral mass for our brother in Christ, Ascension Carmona, we begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our response to this first phrase shall be with your spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. At this time, we shall bless our brother's coffin with holy water to remind us of his baptism. In the waters of baptism, my brother died with Christ. We now share with him eternal glory. I did invite his two older daughters to step forward to unfold the funeral pall. This white funeral pall reminds us of our brother's baptismal graces. Those who are familiar with our interest hymn, please do join in singing.
Let us rejoice.
O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant, our brother Ascension, whom we have called to journey to you. And since he hoped and believed in you, grant that he may be led to our true homeland, to delight in his everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated, as we do have readings from Sacred Scripture. I'd like to invite our first reader to come forward.
El justo, aunque muera prematuramente, haya el descanso. La ancianidad venerable no es la de los muchos días, ni se mide por el número de años. La verdadera canicie para el hombre es la prudencia, y la edad provecta una vida inmaculada. Agradó a Dios y fue amado. Y como vivía entre pecadores, fue trasladado, fue arrebatado para que la maldad no pervirtiera su inteligencia o el engaño sedujera su alma, pues la fascinación del mal empaña el bien y los vaivenes de la concupiscencia corrompen el espíritu ingenuo. Alcanzando en breve la perfección, llenó largos años. Su alma era del agrado del Señor. Por eso se apresuró a sacarle de entre la maldad. Lo ven las gentes, no lo comprenden, ni caen en cuenta. Que la gracia y la misericordia son para sus elegidos, y su visita para sus santos. Palabra de Dios. Te alabamos, Señor.
My shepherd, there is nothing I should. my soul.
Mirad, os revelo un misterio. No moriremos todos, mas todos seremos transformados. En un instante, en un pestañear de ojos, al toque de la trompeta final, pues sonará la trompeta, los muertos resucitarán, incorruptibles, y nosotros seremos transformados. En efecto, es necesario que este ser corruptible se revista de incorruptibilidad y que este ser mortal se revista de inmortalidad. Y cuando este ser corruptible se revista de incorruptibilidad y este ser mortal se revista de inmortalidad, entonces se cumplirá la palabra que está escrita: la muerte ha sido devorada
¿Dónde está, oh muerte, tu victoria? ¿Dónde está, oh muerte, tu aguijón? El aguijón de la muerte es el pecado, y la fuerza del pecado, la ley. Pero gracias sean dadas a Dios, que nos da la victoria por nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Palabra de Dios.
I do wish to humbly extend my condolences to Sun Jiang's family, especially his wife Maribel, and their three daughters, and his mom and dad, and all the family and friends who gathered here at Holy Family Parish. Our brother Sun Jiang was born August 23, 1979, and sadly passed away unexpectedly July 14, 2020, at the age of 40. He's at least survived by his wife Maribel, and they're blessed to be married for 21 years. He's also blessed to have three daughters, which he survived by, and his parents and his siblings, his sisters. And talking to his wife and one of his sisters, I learned that he faithfully served our country in the U.S. Army for 15 years, including two tours in Afghanistan and one tour in Iraq. He was awarded many medals, many service medals, including the Bronze Stars. But he also loved the outdoors. He took joy in fishing and hiking, and kayaking, especially with his daughters. But he also was a man of daily prayer. We must remember that real men take up prayer and defend their families spiritually. He loved his family very much. So I would encourage the family, remember these good things. I think the sisters have more than one story about how he was a prankster and could be very serious, but was just pulling a prank on them. I don't know those stories, but you do. Share them with one another. And so as we strive to remember the good things in our brother's life, in our brother Sun Jiang's life, we also must face the tragic reality that he died in his sleep at the age of 40. We do not know when the good Lord will call us home, but nonetheless, let's call to mind the words from our first reading. The just man, though he die early, shall be at rest. Yet even if we find consolation from our scriptures today, we still want to cry out to our God in heaven the question of why. Why did our brother Ascension have to die at such a young age? It is okay to pray that question of why, to ask the question of why, if you do so in faith and respect. Why is that okay? Because our Lord Jesus, as he hung upon the cross, cried out the question of why. Did our Lord not say, when he hung upon the cross, my God, why have you forsaken me? We know that he's praying the first line of Psalm 22. It is a psalm of entrustment. It's actually very prophetic. If you pray through that psalm, it really describes what our Lord Jesus went through on the cross, hundreds of years before it even happened. So I'd encourage you, maybe today or tomorrow, open up your Bibles, pray through Psalm 22. Then also pray through Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. There's nothing I shall want, which we prayed at this Mass. But if you ask the question of why, ask God also the question of what. What do we do in response to a tragedy, to a crisis, to a hardship? And so, what is God calling you to do in the midst of this response? Definitely pray for one another. Pray for the daughters. Pray for the family. Pray for the parents. But also pray that our brother may rest in peace. We must be people of prayer. But also, to answer your question of why, it comes down to the sad reality that our first parents, Adam and Eve, they disobeyed God by eating of the fruit of knowledge of good and evil. Their sinful disobedience brought illness, disease, suffering, and pain, and death into our world. And we, as their descendants, still suffer through that. But if we also quiet the question of what to God, you know, and why, we must also know that God himself asked himself, what must I do to save the human family that I created in my own image and likeness that I love so much? The short answer to the question of what is one word, Jesus. In the fullness of time, our Heavenly Father sent his Son, our Lord Jesus, to save us and to redeem us. So in the midst of our sorrows and loss, do trust that our Lord Jesus Christ loved our brother Ascension so much that he's willing to die on the cross for him. Let's remember that our Lord Jesus, in his suffering and death, saved our brother. But he did not save us from suffering and death. Our Lord Jesus saved us by suffering and dying on the cross, but he did not save us from suffering and death. Our Lord was very clear. He said, pick up your cross and follow me. But even our Lord Jesus did not do that by himself. He had help carrying his cross to Calvary. Simon of Cyrene helped him. And so we must help one another carry our crosses in pain and suffering. But amidst of all this, back to the question of what? What must I do to save the human family? God our Father said, I will send my Son Jesus. And our Lord Jesus was incarnate of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And he was born on that first Christmas day. We must remember that our Lord Jesus was not born into a rich and powerful family. Our Lord Jesus was born into a humble, working class family. Joseph was a carpenter. Mary was a mother at home, a housewife. There's great dignity in that. And when he was born in a cave. We make it look nice and pretty during Christmas, but it was a cave that was meant to keep animals. You might say a type of barn. Our Lord was born in a barn, laid in a manger. Manger is not a crib. A manger is a feeding trough. So our Lord humbled himself out of love for our brother Ascension, and for each one of us. And so he comes to the ends of the earth to save us. And he takes upon the name Emmanuel. What does Emmanuel mean? It means God is with us. And so, in the midst of all this, our Lord, born of the Blessed Virgin Mary, would save us and proclaim the good news of the gospel. But then in the end, He would suffer his great passion. He would die on the cross. And this is why we are baptized. In our baptism, we are buried into Christ's death, when we rise with him to new life in the resurrection. I know his mom and dad remember when he was baptized, you know, most likely a small child or a little baby. There was an Easter candle also at his baptism. He was clothed in white. That's why we blessed his coffin with holy water, to remind us of his baptismal graces. He became an adopted son of God. And also this is why we have this Easter candle here, to remind us that he received the light of Christ into his life. And let us remember, as I said, just as our Lord Jesus had helped carrying his cross to Calvary, we too must help one another carry our crosses. Our Lord Jesus did not save us from suffering and death, but he did save us through his suffering and death. But also, let's remember that our Lord rose from the dead on the third day. We long for the resurrection. Our Lord would return on the last day in glory. And our brother Ascension shall rise from his grave. When that happens, we don't get our old body back. You know, who wants that? You know, whether it's having a receding hairline, you know, or having to go off to war to defend your country. And the resurrection, not only to be a glorified body, which there's going to be no suffering, pain, or death, we'll also have a perfect heart that beats in perfect love, just as Christ's sacred heart beats in perfect love for us, and actually was pierced by a lance in love for us. What does that mean? No more needing to be in the army. No more needing to lock your front door. We will love one another perfectly, and we long for that. We hope for that. We have faith in that, and we trust in that. But between now and then, and faith, we know that our Lord Jesus has prepared a place for our brother Ascension in heaven. It's still very important for us to pray for him. As long as we're alive, we pray for our deceased relatives as the last great act of charity that we could do for them. But as our Lord said in the gospel today, take these words to heart. Yes, he said these words to his disciples nearly 2,000 years ago. But he says this to his disciples back then. He's saying to us now, we are his disciples, and he says, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. My Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? If I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. I know there's great pain and sorrow. I know a homily can't wipe that away. But please take to heart, this is our great hope for our brother Ascension, and for us as well. Let us trust in God. He is faithful. He is our good shepherd who has not abandoned us, who leads us into life everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let us stand. My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, which intercedes for his church. Confident God hears the voice of those who trust the Lord, we join our prayers to his. After we do lift up our prayers, after each one, please respond, Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, hear our prayers.
In baptism, brother Ascension, receive the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now, lead him over the waters of death, we pray, O Lord.
Lord,
our brother Ascension was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome to the halls of your heavenly kingdom, we pray, O Lord.
Lord,
many friends and many family members and friends have gone before us to await the kingdom of God. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son in heaven, we pray, O
Lord.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly sins against your love, and and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace, we pray to the Lord. Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord. The family and friends of our brother Ascension seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord. We're assembled here in faith and confident pray for our brother. Strengthen our hope that we may live in expectation of your son's glorious return. We pray to the Lord. And after this prayer, next prayer, please respond, Amen. Lord God, give her peace and heal our souls. Hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated as we prepare the altar for the holy sacrifice of the Mass. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable by God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifices.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, our brother Ascension, we beseech your mercy, that he who do not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful, Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, eternal dwellings made ready for them in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as with God, and we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy.
You therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition to Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy unblemished sacrifices, which are offered firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant your peace, to guard, unite, and govern throughout the whole world. Together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Joe, our Bishop, and all those holding to the truth hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your service, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer the sacrifice of praise, or the offer for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and the hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven, to your God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you're pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father, in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us in this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, and may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servant, our brother Ascension, who has gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, life, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share and fellowship with the holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not waiting our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. So the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we do dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we always may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait in the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof, but only say the word to my soul. Let perpetual light shine upon him, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon him, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. For distribution of Holy Communion, we'll do sections at a time. I'll do this section over here first with the family, and so this section will be on the ash, remain kneeling. And once it's done, I'll shift over. For those who are Catholic, not aware of serious sins to be confessed, or if it's been more than 1 year since your last confession, you need to go to confession first before receiving Holy Communion. While we may not extend Holy Communion to our brothers and sisters from other faith denominations, you are welcome to come forward to receive a blessing. Wish to receive a blessing, please indicate this by crossing both your arms over your chest like this. And as you approach Holy Communion, I humbly ask you to remove your mask right before you receive. And if you wish to receive Holy Communion in a tongue, I'm more than happy to do that. I'm comfortable doing that.
All I long for, I have found.
God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Sinchion may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways and take leave of our brother, may our farewell express our love and affection for him. May it also ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again. The love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Our response shall be, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul
and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual life shine upon. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Now, to this next prayer, please respond, Amen. Into your hands, Father, of mercy, we do commend our brother Ascension and the sure and certain hope. Together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with you on the last day. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant. And help us remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, and we all meet in Christ, and with you, with our brother, forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we do prepare to take our brother to his final resting place, we'll do it in stages. I would invite the pallbearers and the immediate family, his wife, the children, his mom and dad, to process out with us. Once we've processed out, I will dismiss one section of time to kind of avoid us grouping up and to trying to do our best to keep our social distance. So in peace, let's take our brother.